A brain freeze. We all know what it is, but why does it happen, other than the fact that you just ate a lot of cold stuff way too fast? Well, first of all, we should call it what it is. Otherwise known as an ice cream headache or a cold stimulus headache, it is scientifically dubbed a spheno-palatine ganglioneuralgia. Yeah, try saying that one 5 times fast. I dare ya. It starts with the cold food or liquid entering your mouth and hitting the roof of your mouth or the palate. When this happens, the blood vessels in the roof of your mouth constrict, a natural reaction known as vasoconstriction. Vasoconstriction makes sense as a body reaction. If you're outside in the cold, you don't want to lose body heat, so your blood vessels constrict, reducing their surface area and holding tight to as much body heat as they can. So now the blood vessels in the roof of your mouth are constricted, but now the ice cream is gone and your mouth warms back up again because you ate it too fast and you didn't give your mouth time to adjust to the temperature of your food. So now your blood vessels open way up again. Time for the headache. This rebound dilation is sensed by pain receptors in your mouth connected to the trigeminal nerve. This nerve extends to 3 different places on your face. The ophthalmic nerve extends to your eyes, nose, and forehead. The maxillary nerve extends to your sinuses, palate, and midface. And your mandibular nerve extends to your mandible, or jaw. Fun fact, the trigeminal nerve is mostly involved in sensing, but it is also involved in some motor functions like chewing. So the trigeminal nerve senses the rapid dilation of the blood vessels in your mouth and thinks it's pain and sends that message to your brain. But your brain gets a little confused. It thinks that the pain is coming from one of the other sensory spots that your trigeminal nerve serves. Your forehead. And then after about a 10-second delay of eating, cooling, constricting, heating, dilating, and confused brains, you get a headache. This can be avoided, you know. Eating slower, letting your mouth adjust to the temperature of the food, or not cramming wicked cold food into your mouth really fast are always to avoid a brain freeze. But where's the fun in that? Go forth, do science.